Hey you guys, in this video I am simply going to be softly speaking with you and doing hand movements, a bit of finger fluttering, nail tapping, and just a little bit of this and that, hopefully just to relax you and have you kind of just follow my hand movements and get you a bit rested and relaxed. Unable to put out a video last night. I apologize for that. I wrote in the community tab that I would not be able to put out a video and told you guys that I was sorry, but it had been a very weird week. We'll share a bit about that in a moment, but I wanted to see just how you guys were doing. What do you have going through your mind at the moment? What kind of things have you been thinking about, processing? Life can be a lot sometimes, and you may be processing quite a bit. So feel free to share. How are you doing? Because I have found that this is a very nice community, a very kind community, and I think a lot of people go through similar things here, so feel free to share and encourage one another a bit. I have a friend who got in a bad accident this week, and the friend is okay, but it's thrown me off quite a bit, actually. So I apologize for some inconsistency on my part. I needed to just, you know, that's a lot when you have someone you care about. When you have someone that you care about who's gotten badly injured, it does take up some space in the brain. Yeah, so that has been the weird thing in my week. There's been other weird things, actually. That's been more like the painful thing in the week. But, weird week, you guys, weird week. Life is a bit weird sometimes. Go ahead and just follow my fingers and my hands as they move across the screen. They're moving up and down, across and back, across and back, down. some finger flutters near the mic up here. There's a new channel I mentioned, it's new to me, a new ASMR channel that I've been liking, and I can't figure out how she does it, but she does these really great sounding hand movements, and like, it's inspiring me. I want to know how she does it. It's called, the channel's called Simply Kel. I think her name is Kelly, so she goes by Simply Kel, and there's just something about the way that she moves her hands. Oh, I love it. You should check it out. Maybe it's like, maybe she's doing that a bit. Anyway, it's very talented. I want to learn her ways of how she does that because I feel like it's a great trigger. So, one thing that I'm going to hopefully do today or tomorrow is, I've shared this many times on the channel, but if you're new to the channel, first of all, welcome, thank you for being here. And I have like an injury along my ulnar nerve, it's called, goes through your neck, down through the back, your elbow, and through your pinky finger. And this nerve has been injured for me from a previous job. I love typing and I just was typing way too fast in a position that was not ergonomic. I didn't say that right, did I? Ergonomics. It was not right ergonomically, I'm not sure. But I was not sitting properly and this was years ago. And so I've had this injury for quite a while actually, and about a year and a half, 2 years ago, I started taking turmeric capsules that have something in them called biopeperin, and that ingredient helps your body to absorb the turmeric, from what I understand. And so I had a turmeric is a great anti-inflammatory. So if you have inflammation, which is what I have, turmeric can really, really, really help. But I had tried it before and it hadn't done much until someone suggested to me you need to get the turmeric pills that have biopeperin because it helps your body absorb it, so you actually can, that your body can use it for that anti-inflammatory purpose. And so once I started taking those capsules, I saw a huge difference. And again, I had dealt with this for many years and nothing was working, not even physical therapy, which physical therapy usually works quite well for me when I've got injuries before. So the fact that really nothing was helping and then the turmeric really, really helped was really, really encouraging. So you can try that. I get mine off of Amazon. However, I am in Egypt right now, and that's not exactly a thing here. They have a version of Amazon, but it's a lot smaller, and they didn't have what I needed. So I'm on a bit of a journey to find my turmeric in Egypt, and I found like an herbal store, which I think might have something like it, but I need to get on that because I only have about like 2 weeks left of my tablets for my turmeric, and it's quite crucial for me in doing ASMR videos because of editing and doing the thumbnails and interacting with you guys on YouTube and Instagram That's actually usually why I'm so bad at Instagram interactions, because I don't have extra hand usage time after I've done my editing and comments and interacting with you guys and thumbnails, etc. Uploading the video. So I'm going to try to find that turmeric today or tomorrow. I actually did go the other day. I found a shop, that shop that I was mentioning, it's like an herbal shop, and but the day I went they were closed, and that's my fault. It was a Friday. Things are closed on Fridays here. I always forget that. Their weekend is like Friday, Saturday. In the US I'm used to Saturday, Sunday being a weekend, but I'm also used to, honestly, most things are open even on Saturdays and Sundays, but here things do close down on Fridays often, certain places, not, it's like kind of random. I actually think it might be a bit random. I think the business might decide if they close on Friday or not. Certain places, like the bank, has distinct clear times when they are closed, and everyone knows that. But then small individually owned businesses, like I found, some of them are open on Friday, some are not. But I should have just like not gone on a Friday just in case. But it's okay, because I found out where the place was, and someone told me that it will open like the following day. And for me, that's a win. Usually victories for me and little wins for me in Egypt are really like just figuring little things out, even if I don't actually complete the task. I am like a small child here. It's kind of like I'm always learning every second new things and taking, it's like very baby step. But you don't realise how much you're learning each day through the mistakes you make and through just trying things. You know, you just like kind of try to find, for me it's turmeric today, I'm trying to find turmeric. That means I learned that, okay, you don't go to a local larger store for that, you have to find like a specialty store for that. And it's just kind of cool, because you know, when you think about it, if you're learning 3 or 4 smaller things like that in a day, over a month, you've really learned quite a bit about that culture and how to live there and what life is like. And but yeah, it's a lot to learn at once sometimes as an adult. Kids have the advantage of like a parent like walking around holding them, taking them places, teaching them. Whereas when you're an adult and you're doing funny random things, it's not always as well accepted. I'm knocking on the door of that place and like all the people sitting around me just like on the street are like, they're not open, what are you doing, it's a Friday, come back tomorrow. And I'm like, oh yeah, that's right. It's just a little bit more embarrassing as an adult. As the twins that I talk about often, she's French, she's half French, half American, and she's lived in America now for a long time, even though she grew up in France, and speaks French fluently, speaks English fluently. Like when she speaks in one of the languages, anyone who's native to that language knows she's a native speaker. It's rare that people speak two languages with zero accent in either. They are completely fluent, and nobody would understand that this person isn't 100% American or 100% French. So she sort of has this issue that when she travels to France, she has a similar experience of what I just described. Like she might go to a post office or something that anybody that's French as an adult would know very easily, of like how to function in that space, how to use that space. And she walks in, is like, where do I get this? And like the, it completely sounds French, looks French. It's like they just look at her like, how could you possibly not know that? She's like, I sound the part, but I don't live here, and I haven't for some time. And it's, she gets that. Even in the US sometimes, she feels like, oh man, people think I'm like so weird because I don't know this like common topic or whatever it is, because she sounds like she should. Something very, very basic to American culture or something, and she doesn't know because she did not grow up here. So she said the same thing, like, it's a bit embarrassing as an adult when I'm walking through France asking other adults questions that they're like, how would you not know the answer to that? I wonder if it would help if she just like pretended to not speak fluently. Make a few mistakes in there. I'm joking. This is one of the dresses that I purchased in 4 colours because I liked it a lot. This one you can't quite see because I've got kind of a bright light behind me. And it's more, I was trying to film in a darker spot, but that's quite bright. I'm sorry about that, I just realised. But yeah, you can't quite see, but it's actually a turquoise colour. Looks a lot darker with the shadowing that I'm in currently. So I got this in a purple, in a kind of blush pink, a light turquoise, maybe even teal, and then this darker turquoise, and then one that's like I guess a magenta. I was thinking to do like a clothing scratching video soon, like where I'm wearing jeans and scratching. I feel like I've gotten a few requests for that lately, so that's been on my mind to get you guys a video like that. And I'm also still planning on having you guys vote on, just kind of want to hear those of you that really like the mic when I'm speaking kind of live in a whispered or soft spoken video, which I don't do as often now, or the voiceovers for soft spoken and whispered videos. There's pros and cons to both, but I found that I can get better sounds when I do voiceovers. But I know that you like when I'm moving with, talking with you, which I totally understand. I like that too. And when I'm more settled, it might take some time to kind of figure out where I'm going to settle, first of all. I do hope to at some point get maybe a Zoom recorder again. I don't know still though. I sort of feel like the voiceover is even more clear, but I'm going to try and do a vote for you guys because I want to. I keep getting comments of people that really like one and really like the other, so I kind of want to see the percentage so I can kind of balance out the videos for you guys that way. If that makes sense. So you guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and thank you for all of your support of this channel and your encouragement, and you just keep encouraging me with the videos and appreciating them, and I'm really thankful for that. It really does make a difference, and I'm thankful that you like them. Please do keep giving me your ideas and feedback so I know what you guys are liking and not really liking, or that I could do better, that sort of thing. It's is very helpful. I read your comments the best that I can, especially when it's within a few days of the video going up. I usually am able to go through the comments that are there at that point. So if you have gotten to the end of this video with me, I'm going to choose an emoji for you to put in the comment section. This time I'm going to give you 3 emojis to put in a row. I don't know why, but I think that might be fun. So let's go tiger first, grapes second, and third the like waves. There's like a waves emoji. Tiger, grapes, waves. Why? I do not know. Let's see how that works. I'm curious. I'll say it again so you don't have to like rewind or something. Tiger, grapes, waves. Tiger, grapes, waves. Tiger, grapes, waves. Tiger, grapes, waves. This is getting weird. Alright, you guys. I hope you have a good rest of your day or night. And I do hope to see you in the next video. Thank you so much.